Hello again, all you crazy Shakespeare lovers. It's Cameron, your Hard for the Bard, once again. First of all, before I do anything else, I want to just thank you all of you that were able to watch and share things with me last week after the first Sonnet vlog. I'm really, really appreciative of that. I'm really happy that you got something out of it, that you enjoyed it. I got a little bit of feedback on the vlog, and so I'm going to start adding the sonnet within inline and Tumblr as well, so you don't have to click all the way through to go view it at YouTube. But that's pretty much the only feedback I got, so apparently not enough of you guys are watching these. I'm just kidding. But seriously, if you guys have any suggestions for me at all, if you have any suggestions for how I can make this better, or any way that would maybe get you guys to participate a little bit more, I'd love to hear from you. But other than that, thank you for watching, thank you for commenting, thank you for sharing, and let's do number two, yeah? When 40 winters shall besiege thy brow and dig deep trenches in thy beauty's field, thy youth's proud livery, so gazed on now, will be a tattered weed of small worth held. Then being asked, where all thy beauty lies, where all the treasure of thy lusty days, to say within thine own deep sunken eyes were an all-eating shame and thriftless praise. How much more praise deserved thy beauty's use, if thou couldst answer, this fair child of mine shall sum my count and make my old excuse, proving his beauty by succession thine. This were to be new made when thou art old, and see thy blood warm when thou feel'st it cold. So there you go. Sonnet 2 is not one of the more critical of the sonnets. When I say that, I don't mean that it's not important. I just mean there's not a lot of critique on it. But just a couple things. So 40 winters typically refers to a long period of time. The origin of that phrase is 40 winters or 40 years, which is how long Moses and his followers spent in the wilderness. It's a Lenten amount of time. So when 40 winters besiege thy brow, so long enough that you've not been eating and you've been wandering the wilderness for 40 years, you're going to look pretty old and nasty after that, you know? That anybody who's fasted for 40 years can tell you that. So anyway, there's some really interesting stress points where they put, like for example, in the second and third lines, dig deep trenches in thy beauty's field, thy youth's proud livery so gazed on now. If emphasis is put on the thy, it changes the meaning of that phrase, those two lines. So if the stress is placed on thy, it's implied that the speaker's brow is already wrinkled. So, and dig deep trenches in thy beauty's field, thy youth's proud livery so gazed on now. Because of the emphasis, it becomes much more sarcastic. It also changes the iams, so it really depends on how you want to read it. Because when you change the iam in that way, sometimes it can create a feminine ending, and you know, we'll get into that later. I don't want to take up too much time on the end of this video talking about iams. But if that's something you're interested in, let me know in the comments. So in line 6, our dear Shakespeare refers to all the treasure of thy lusty days. So lusty days referring to youthful days, days when you were virile and lustful and fun, basically. Because essentially what this poem is you should have sex with me and reproduce with me because you don't want to waste your looks on just yourself. Come on. One of the funny things that I also want to bring up about this is it's written about procreation and about passing your good looks onto your child, but the person it's being written to does not sound feminine in the slightest, which is another very funny thing that Billy liked to do, was to write poems that would typically be written to women to young men. And then in the last few lines of the first part of the sonnet here, we have, if thou couldst answer, this fair child of mine shall sum my count and make my old excuse. So make excuse for my old age by creating the sum of what I used to look like. But an alternate view of that could be, you know, it may be old excuse may actually refer to the argument that Shakespeare made in the first sonnet. So shall sum my count and make my old excuse. So use the method that I told you about in Sonnet 1 to make yourself continue on being beautiful. And I think as I go through all these sonnets week after week, you'll start to see that there are very few of them that are one-offs. A lot of them seem to be, here's a sonnet about something, and the next sonnet is, you remember what I said in that sonnet before this? Well, here's why I said it. And the third sonnet, oh, well, remember those other two sonnets? That there's something else I want to tell you. And a lot of them are like that. They're grouped as series sometimes. So as we go forward, I may change the layout a little bit. I may do multiple sonnets at once. We'll see. I really just want feedback from you guys. So I hope you're enjoying this. That's it for Sonnet 2. And have a great day, guys.